We're the B Sisters, Holly Brochmann and Leah Bowen, and we're the authors of the series A Feel Better Book for Little Kids, illustrated by Shirley Ink Benitez and published by Magination Press, the children's imprint of the American Psychological Association. Today we're going to read our latest book, A Feel Better Book for Little Sports, and it's all about sportsmanship, playing on a team, and winning and losing gracefully. So let's get started. Okay, A Feel Better Book for Little Sports. Here we go. All over the world, in all different places, people of all ages, genders, and races share a love for sports. They're so much fun. Yippee! Hooray! Your team has won! Sports bring us together. Our passion unites us. The thrill of the game totally excites us. Sports are terrific in so many ways. The list of why could go on for days. For one thing, sports are so good for you. They exercise your body and your brain too. When your body works harder, your heart becomes stronger, your lungs can breathe better, your energy lasts longer. From the running and jumping to the kicking and throwing, show me those muscles. See how they're growing? Meanwhile, your mood is also improving. Your brain gets a boost from all of that moving. Speaking of brains, there's so much to learn, like how good it feels to get something you earn. But remember, it's not all about getting that win. Sportsmanship matters just as much in the end. Have respect for your teammates and the other side too. Listen to your coaches when they're talking to you. Always be courteous, considerate, and kind. You can still be tough at the same time. You be the one when someone falls down to run over and help them up from the ground. And when your team wins, have compassion and grace. Treat the winners the same as the ones in last place. Go ahead, celebrate, cheer with everyone. It's okay to be proud of what you have done. But also remember those on the losing side. They're probably feeling they've lost their pride. Shake their hands and say, thanks for the game. Next time the score might not be the same. But what happens when games don't go your way? You're feeling frustrated and don't want to play. It's a swing, a pass, a kick, and a miss. It's not fun anymore when sports are like this. You're losing the game, so you're losing your temper. You want to throw all your stuff or yell at a team member. But that's the thing about sports. You can't always win. The excitement of trying is what keeps you in. So don't spoil the fun by losing your head. When you're feeling frustrated, try this instead. Step away from the game. Take your own time out. It's better to pause than to scream and shout. Place your hand on your heart. Feel it beat in your chest. Then take several deep breaths to help with the stress. You'll begin to calm down in a minute or two. Now get back in the game. Your teammates need you. Finally, remember, these feelings won't stay. Don't let this one game ruin your day. So whether playing in a rink, on the field, or the court, above all, remember, be a good sport. The end. And now, a simple but effective activity you can do is to pass the ball back and forth and talk about the game. So for example, what was something that was really hard about the game today?
When the other team was being really aggressive and I was getting frustrated.
What was something that you were super proud about today?
When I shot the ball from really far away and it went in.
What was something that was so fun that you did today?
When we won the game and we all celebrated afterward.
A few more questions you could ask are, What was something you wish you could do differently for next time? What was something you loved that you did that you would like to do again? What was something that made you feel good inside about today's game? You can pass the ball back and forth. You can kick a soccer ball back and forth or throw a football. You get the idea. Pass the ball, read the book, and have some fun. Thanks for listening to us read a Feel Better book for little sports.
Thanks. See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.